friends, how are you today? We started this journey yesterday where we're planning on going on a 40-day looking at this amazing book that I looked at and that gave me some of the answers to most of our problems, and it's called The Purpose Driven Life, written by Rick Warren. Now, I've suggested this book to so many people because I read a few chapters and I could see a big difference in, or I could really tell that this was making sense. And there was a part that I read that really scared me to the point that I had to just get on with life and do things. And I stopped at that stage and I didn't continue reading. But right now, with all the things I've been going through, I realized that it's absolutely necessary to fall back into my spirit and get to understand myself a lot more. And then the idea came, why not go back to this purpose-driven life? Because it's about the purpose, it's about why we're here. There's a book called Man's Search for Meaning. Things like that really get to me, like, we want to know what our mission is on this earth. We want to know why we are here. We want to know why things are not happening the way we humans are thinking about it. So I decided I'm going to take this on. And when I looked at the book, which I hadn't looked at the time, it's actually a 40 days journey, which I explained yesterday. So today actually starts our day one, and we're going to go chapter by chapter. It's actually 40 chapters. And I want us to work together on this. Idea is you could go and buy your copy and then we'll work together as I'm going through it as well. Or you could just relax back and hear my take on the things that I've been able to read through. So thoughts that were coming to me even starting today is we should know that we are the missing link in life. There used to be a program called The Missing Link. We are the missing link. Missing link in the sense of life. Okay, so continue our journey on this trip, the 40 days new beginning or new life. Today is actually day one. And what we're saying is we are the missing link in life. And the question was why? The Bible has been here forever, for centuries and centuries and centuries. And generations have come and gone, and just like us, we are going to come and go. And our question then becomes, what are we doing here? Hence this book, Purpose Driven Life. And I've always said, we all have a mission for being here. So the question we want to ask ourselves now is, why are we here? Where have we come from? There's a book called Man's Search for Meaning, and it's all about these questions. Where are we going? And my understanding is, it's not about life. Life is not where the problem is. We are the issue. Because just like generations have come and gone, and they did well, those who did amazing things and those who didn't do much of an amazing thing, we are here to make that difference. And so we need to look into ourselves to see where is the problem. Everything we need is here, just like generations have been and seen and gone. Our Creator sent us here complete. Everything we needed to survive on this earth, we already have it. Our confusion about life is right here. And so we find ourselves lacking and needing and seeking and searching constantly. It's our understanding that's got the problem. Ignorance is where our problem is. And you know of that saying that knowledge is power. Once you have knowledge, you have power. And in the Bible, Solomon said it in Proverbs, Proverbs 4:7. He said, above all things, the first thing we should do in whenever we're doing anything, is to seek understanding. Understanding is the key to life. And I've read in so many places, and it's all coming down to that same thing called knowledge or understanding or awareness. In Hosea chapter 4 again, verse 6, says, "My people suffer for lack of knowledge." So all this suffering that we're going through on earth is because of lack of knowledge, is because of lack of understanding, is because of lack of awareness. Bob Proctor, this guy I watch on YouTube a lot, that's the biggest thing he throws at me. Awareness. And what you find is things get really difficult when we are not aware of what that is, when we have no understanding of what that is. So our journey in this 40-day book that we're looking at is to gain that understanding. The journey will give us a new understanding, and it will remind us that whatever it is we're dealing with starts with us. And that's why I'm calling it a new life, or a new beginning, as you may want to call it, or a new mind. We're going to create a new mind, a mindset that begins to see things differently. You find some Christians, there's a Christian group that says being born again. The Bible also says that. We have to be born again. Born again means your mind is renewed. And that's what Eckhart Tolle calls a new awakening. So when you were sleeping all along, which is where the ignorance is, and suddenly you wake up, that's why he calls it a new awakening. So we need to look at how we're going to renew our mind to start our life afresh. So yesterday I took my time to start, which makes today the first day. And what I did say was, you can go order this book on Amazon. It's absolutely an amazing book, because everyone who's actually taking their time to read through it, they've always come back with amazing testimonials about what they experienced. So chapter one, which I started yesterday, and the very first chapter says, it all starts with God. So it all starts with God. And I wanna just explain here, I'm a Christian, and I don't wanna force my religion on anyone, but whatever religion you tend to go with, take it from that point of view. This is going to give you a new mindset. So I may be telling you what I personally believe in. You can work with yours. But whatever we are on this earth starts with God. So what you understand as your creator is what you're going to be working with. It all flows from the mind. So yes, I absolutely believe in God, my creator. And that's how the message in this book goes. But whatever you believe in, remember there is a creator. You did not pop here from nowhere, you started from somewhere. And who created you is what you should be asking yourself. So it starts with God. And this chapter is saying, it's not about me. So what I've done yesterday, I did say that if you can get yourself some little cards, and whatever major points we can pick out, we'll just be writing on the cards. And then after looking at the cards, we'll then look at the chapter. What I did was I just underlined a few things that really popped out in my eyes. So the purpose of your life is far greater than your own personal fulfillment. And this is a big message for all of us, because we tend to remember most times that we have a creator and we have God when things start to go the way we don't want them to happen. And so when you find yourself in really difficult positions or situations, then you go, oh my goodness, where am I? I remember a story once about this young lady. This is some time ago now, here in England. And she was constantly, I don't believe in God, I don't want to know. And she was what you call celebrity. And somehow she then caught this really, she became very ill with cancer. And then suddenly she's all God-fearing now. She had to get her children baptized in church, and she was begging people that when she dies they should please take her to church. And you know, so why do we wait until things go really, really wrong with us? But anyway, so that's what this message is trying to give us. Purpose of your life is far greater than your own personal fulfillment. So all of us are just waiting out there to just grab in the world, and we're not remembering that there's more to who we are than just this person that wants things. And so if you want to know why you were placed on this planet, you must begin with God. You were born by His purpose and for His purpose. That's a big message. You were born by His purpose and for His purpose. And so when you start asking yourself major serious questions like that, why am I here? Remember, it starts with God. And focusing on ourselves will never reveal our life's purpose. So just like I said, if it's always about me, and what else can I have, and what else do I need, and you will never find out what your purpose is on this earth if that's your mindset. It is God who directs the lives of His creatures. Everyone's life is in His power. So if you understand you were created by God, then your life is in His power. You must begin with God. You exist because God wills that you exist, and you were made by God and for God. It is only in God that we discover our origin. So who are we, and why are we here? What are we doing here, and what's our mission here? So these are the questions we ask constantly. But once we remember that God is the reason we're here, oh, believe me, by the time we're done with this book, a lot will change in your mindset. I've already seen the changes. Just yesterday I decided to start reading little bits, and it's all opening up. Because, like I said earlier, the answer is right here. Everything we want is here. And if you keep reminding yourself that generations have come and gone, and you know that for us, it's in Proverb, Solomon said it. He says what? No, Ecclesiastes. I have the passage somewhere. He says, for everything that is born, there's time for everything. Not just everything that's born. There's time for everything. A time to be happy, a time to be sad, a time to be born, and a time to die. So there's time for everything. It's all been set. God has set it all. So no matter what you think you are, no matter what you have mentally created, Eckhart Tolle calls it the ego. So this ego that has formed this person that you see, which is not the real you, that's not you. The real you is here for a reason. The real you, and it's not about that ego that's been born. And you know, something I've always talked about is when a child is born, the mind is blank. So we have this child born, empty mind. In that world they call it tabula rasa. It's an empty mind. Nothing is in there. Our mind is like a sponge. What it does, it just picks up everything around it. Everything around it. And so that's how you find that even twins born in the same place and raised in different places comes up with different characteristics. Because it's the environment, it's the school, is the church, is the friends, everyone around you influences your way of thinking. So that's where the issue is. So we need to understand that life is about letting God use us for His purpose. We need to try and understand that that's what we're here for God to use us for His purpose. And this book is going to start opening our mind to understand what this is all about. So discover God's purpose either. So he says there are two ways we discover God's purposes. One is by speculation. And speculation is when we now imagine, or we're thinking in our head that, oh yeah, this is it. I think this is what I'm actually meant to be doing here. I think. And so we're speculating. And he goes further to explain that even all the great philosophers on this earth, and scientists and writers and intellectuals in the world have been consulted to try and explain what it is that we're here to do. And even they came back with no answers, because they don't know. And so the second way we can understand our purpose is by revelation. And that's what I think this book is going to be trying to tell us, is by revelation. So one of the biggest verses that he came up with, it says, everything got started in him and finds its purpose in him. So that's Colossians 1 verse 16. Life is really about living for God, not for yourself. So life is really about living for God, not for yourself. And so that's the little bits I have on my day one card. And I'll just look at some of the passages and paragraphs or lines that I underlined. He says the purpose of your life is far greater than your own personal fulfillment, which I mentioned already. Your peace of mind, or even your happiness, those are not, God's purpose is bigger than that. And he's going to make it very, very clear to you as we go along, and you get a bigger message out of this book. If you want to know why you were placed on this planet, you must begin with God. You were born by his purpose and for his purpose. We just got a question. Someone asking, what's the name of this book? It's Purpose Driven Life. Purpose Driven Life. And is by Rick Warren. If you go onto Amazon and type that in, you will definitely see this book. It's been sold, 30 million copies sold worldwide so far. Something about Rick Warren that's really amazing. He says the purpose-driven life will help you understand why you are alive and reveal God's amazing plan for you, both here and now, and for eternity. Rick Warren will guide you through a personal 40-day spiritual journey that will transform your life, transform your answer to life's most important question. What on earth am I here for? Knowing God's purpose for creating you will reduce your stress, focus your energy, simplify your decisions, give meaning to your life, and most important, prepare you for eternity. I have the book. Oh, you have the book. That's amazing. So we're carrying on this journey, and it's a 40-day journey, and the very place I am now is chapter one. Thank you for the question. I hope that has helped. So we're going to carry on this journey, and seriously, lots of people who have read this book really, really have come back to say thank you for recommending it. It's very interesting that I hadn't read it. I only read a few chapters and I was so taken aback with the stark reality that he was talking about that scared me so much I just dropped it and I quickly went on to other books. But reality is how to deal with this. And you know, there's somewhere he wrote, he says he's been praying for you all these years before he wrote this book. So for everything we go through in life, God has already guided us. He knows. He knows every issue you're going to deal with. He knows every problems you're going to face. And so he's sitting out there and he's waiting for you to come back. And so that's what's going on here. Somehow when I read where he said he's been praying for you, I just said, you know what, I know you. God, you know me so well, because somehow I needed to come back to this. But what's exciting about this now, which is probably why I didn't read it when I didn't read it, is because I was watching someone on YouTube the other day. I did mention that yesterday. And one of the things he said was, document every journey. Every journey you're taking, document it. And that's that connected with me, because again, I tend to share all my knowledge with everyone, but somehow I was thinking in my head, you know what, this is my own, I'm gonna deal with this, which I've been doing, like all these books I talked about yesterday, Psycho-Cybernetics. I'm very, very into books. Another one, Mind Power. And so I just thought, okay, this is a tough journey, but I'm gonna take it. And what that man said just clicked. I don't know who else is out there dealing with major issues. And so why don't you share it with everyone? And why can't you all go on this journey together? So that's why I decided to make this our journey. All of us go on this journey. You say, focusing on ourselves will never relieve or reveal our life's purposes, which I've said earlier. It is God who directs the lives of his creatures. Everyone's life is in his power. So what I'm just reading are some of the ones that I've underlined that really made sense to me. You won't discover your life's meaning by looking within yourself. That's not where the answer is. You probably tried that already. And I know I have. I have tried so many things. Anyone that knows me knows that I do not stop. I'm constantly on to, once I've got that one, I'm going on to the next one, I'm going to the next one. So it's like, it's a continuous journey. I know what they say, that it's not over until it's over. Life is not over until it's over. So you've finished the journey when you wake up and you still see yourself like, okay, what am I doing today? So that's why this has definitely come on my table now, and I have to deal with it. You say you did not create yourself, so there is no way you can tell yourself what you were created for. That is amazing. Because I see here and I think, oh yeah, I have all the answers. And obviously I read all the books, and trust me, I read the Bible. But you need some guidance. Thanks so much, Lene Kavkakos. Sorry if I'm not pronouncing your name well, but yeah, I'm getting some notes telling me who's on and who's not. So thank you so much for your question, and I hope I've been able to answer it. And thank you so much for engaging with us. We're really, really happy that this is getting your attention. So yes, we are on this journey together, and we're gonna really get there. I believe it in my soul. I just know that this is what we needed to know. So you didn't create yourself, so there is no way you can tell yourself what you were created for. Absolutely true. We sit here and we think we know the answers to everything, but we don't. We don't. It says you must begin with God, your creator. You exist only because God wills that you exist. Now that is really awesome, because you find all kinds of things going on out there in the world, and sometimes I wonder, why am I still here? When you find out that, you know what, you're here because your creator wants you to be here, then that really empowers you, because now you're on a clearer journey, and that's what we're calling a new life. The life we had before, we thought we knew it, but no, apparently we did not. It is only in God that we discover our origin. Every other path leads to a dead end. Now, isn't that scary? Everything else that we think we know, that we think we are chasing. Yesterday I was explaining, I was watching this program on YouTube as well, and someone was mentioning Gary Vee, that's the guy, the one who was saying document every journey. And he was saying he was with, I can't remember the other man's name, but he explained that 50 Cent, that we all know, this musician guy who made so much money, he called the energy water or some water that he was selling, he made so much money out of it. He's gone bankrupt or going bankrupt. Same thing with, can't remember the other man he mentioned, and he equally, Johnny Depp was having this, he's having marital problems, and I think he's having a divorce with his wife, and he equally, with all the millions he made, he's gone bankrupt. And so it just makes you wonder. It's not about money, because money obviously hasn't bought them happiness, and they're still sitting there and struggling with life. So people out there think, most times ordinary people like me and you would think that money is the answer to all the problems in the world, but apparently it's not, because you may still end up being extremely poor in spirit. And spirit is where God resides. This is where we really are who God created. This is where we're not just that ego that we have created here on earth. And so he says, every other path that we have taken so far will lead us to a dead end. He said, life is about letting God use you for his purpose. And this is what we really need to start finding out. Now, what our purpose is in life. And this man, just like me, you've seen all the books I read and all the various things that because I'm constantly educating my mind. He says, I have read many books that suggest ways to discover the purpose of my life. All of them could be classified as self-help. Yes, we've all tried to help ourselves by getting more knowledge, getting more awareness, getting more information, just like we said earlier, where Solomon said we should first of all seek understanding and seek knowledge. But he says the approach the books give us are usually self-centered, which is true, self-centered. And so self-help books, even Christian ones, usually offer the same predictable steps to finding your life's purpose. And it is perfect, because all the things I've been looking at recently and reading are so straight on. He just got the answer. He said, usually they say to you, consider your dreams, clarify your values, set some goals, figure out what you are good at, aim high, go for it. Be disciplined, believe in you, believe you can achieve any goal you want, involve others, never give up. Everything is spot on. And these are the things I say to people as well. I'm always preaching all of this, telling you, don't give up, focus on your dreams, don't let it go, stay on there. And then this is all about achieving goals. And whose goals are these? This is our goals. We are constantly thinking about ourselves all the time. It says you get the goals, you get the success, but this is where it becomes what we're talking about. This is where your mind becomes empty. And this is where you lose your spirit, because we're just listening to all these self-help books. But he explains it, he says, this is not a self-help book. It's not about finding the right career or achieving your dreams or planning your life. It's not about how to cram more activities into an overloaded schedule. That's me. Actually, it will teach you how to do less in life by focusing on what matters most. It's about becoming what God created you to be. And that's the journey I'm on. That's definitely where I want to be. I want to discover my purpose in this life. I want God to guide me and take me to where he actually created me for. And this is where he says the two ways of looking at it is either speculation. And speculation was where what most people choose. This is what most of us choose, where we guess and then we theorize. When people say, I've always thought life is, and then they add whatever, or this is the best guess I can come up with, this is what I think who I am. So for thousands of years, brilliant philosophers have discussed and speculated about the meaning of life. When it comes to determining the purpose of your life, even the wisest philosophers are just guessing. Everyone is just guessing. And he gave some examples of people that have all been chatted with and all that. But even they have no answers. And so this is when he now comes to explain to us. He says, God is not just the starting point of your life. He is the source of it. God is the source of your life. The Bible is there for us to look at, which is like the owner's manual. And we need to really take the Bible seriously. He says, it's in Christ that we find out who we are and where we are living and what we are living for. Long before we first heard of Christ and got our hopes up, he had his eyes on us. He had designs on us for glorious living. Part of the overall purpose he is working out in everything and everyone. He says, you discover your identity and purpose through a relationship with Jesus Christ. If you don't have such a relationship, I will later explain. That's later in the book. But this is where again I say it's down to you, whatever your belief is. But the most important belief here is you are not your own creator. God created you. And for us Christians, it's through Jesus Christ that we receive every love. He said God was thinking of you long before you were ever, before you ever thought about him, which is very true. God was thinking of us long before we even started wondering what is going wrong, why am I not getting there, what else do I need to do. God knew you. His purpose for your life predates your conception. He planned it before you existed, without your input. You had nothing to do with it. You may choose your career, you may choose your spouse, you may choose your hobbies, and many other parts of your life, but you don't get to choose your purpose. You don't know what you're here for. The purpose of your life fits into a much larger cosmic purpose that God has designed for eternity. Without God, life makes no sense. And so, this is where we're going to stop today. And tomorrow, we continue chapter 2. But thank you so much for watching. And I am so really, really revved up for this journey. A new beginning, a new life, a new mindset, a new me. And so I want all of us to renew ourselves for a greater, better life that's coming. The life that God created us for. So we'll see you tomorrow. Thank you.